Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I am so excited for this video. We actually took a family vacation this year and we went to Monrovia, Liberia. Me and my husband are both from Liberia, so we decided this year we really wanted to take our son just to see where we came from. And then of course this was Sam's first time coming back home since he left around, I would say, the age of 4 or 5. And last year was my first time coming back to Liberia since I left at age 4. So this was an exciting trip. We knew it was a lot of family time we was going to have, and just being able to just be so appreciative of life, gratitude, family, showing Kenny where we came from, giving him a part of the culture, the experience for us too. Yeah, this video is going to be just going to be a vlog on the things that we did in Liberia. And I actually left some clips out, but again, this video was filled with fun, with family, with faith. What else we have in here? We have a lot of family. So Sam got to meet his father after 30 plus years. He left his dad in Liberia when they moved to the Ivory Coast because of the Civil War. So that was a nice reunion to see, and just see like so many reunions. Kenny got to meet his great-grandpa for the first time. All three of my dads was in Liberia at the same time. So, you know, we got to see them. Sam got to meet my dad for the first time. And what else? A lot of first time meetings. I got to meet Sam's dad, and just everything. It was just so much fun, y'all.
Oh, I should have brought my Savannah.
Places. You want
to? Daddy, turn the camera off. You're
gonna
waste the battery.
No, baby. Recharge it up.
Put it on the tripod.
I'm fine.
So the first thing that I do, actually, I did this last year when I came to Liberia. I came without my hair done. I just washed and blow dry my hair. And the first day, literally, the first day I got my hair braided and I did like these big cornrows. And then the second day, which is this video, we were taking out the hair that I had in for like 4 or 5 days. And now we're going to do the individual. One thing when you're in Africa, like, you gotta get your hair braided. It's a whole nother level. They were super fast. It's the same girl that did my hair the first time. And she's super good, so I kept in contact with her. And she called her other friend. I knew her. And she started on the ends. And then next thing I know, it was 3 people in my head. And my hair went super fast. As you can see, my hair is so full. So they were able to get everything completed. Probably it was less than 5 hours we did this.
Yeah, don't make one. I don't know who left on. We were recording. And I brought it out. How I heard you could cook all. Wow.
Daniel Koha.
Yeah.
Your boss lady?
Yeah, he's a good boy.
No, Daniel Koha. Give me her number, yeah?
Can? Ready to eat? Can, you ready? And a natural African food, yeah. You hear me?
Anything that drops from the tree.
Oh, okay. You play soccer?
No shit. You know all So this was the main highlight of this whole trip. Sam got to see his dad after 30 plus years. Do you guys know what it is to not see your parent for 30 years? I mean, like, no communication, not even talk on the phone, not video call, none of that. In my case, when I saw my mom after 24 years, we still communicated on Facebook Messenger. We video chat, we talked. But for Sam, he didn't have no communication. He didn't know how he looked like. His dad don't know how he looked like. So they were finally about to meet. And this was like super emotional. It didn't all hit me until afterwards, you know, going back and seeing the clips and thinking about the moment, being in there. You just understand, like, God is so faithful in everything he says. His promises are so real. He promises us hope in the future. All his promises are yes and amen. And in his due time, he is the God that he will do things that seem so impossible. He will make it possible. And I'm so glad that I was able to witness such God's faithfulness. It was a gorgeous moment.
Thank you. Hello, hello.
How are you doing?
How are you? I'm playing with my... I'm my pleasure to get. How are you?
Just simply do not want to see with me, your father-in-law.
How are you?
What a blessing.
Yo.
Sam.
Yo.
Hey,
yo. Yeah.
What? Little ball.
Damn.
So crack and bring up
the joy.
I expect you to be dancing around.
I'm
joy. You know what you think over many years. Just in the second for you to appear.
No communication at all. Wow.
Nice
job. I think we're talking about window doing that.
And if you saw rice, somebody, children, they were passing away, right? So why you have to tell them? Thank you so much.
So not only did we get to see a lot of famines in Liberia, but we also just got to escape some days that we wanted to just escape with just all three of us. We went to some our favorite spots. One of my favorite spots in Liberia is definitely the Calabash. Gorgeous spot. It was chill. We went one night. It was super chill. And then we went another night. It was Friday. And it was a lot of people there. But it was really nice to be there. And it's also Liberian owned, which was my favorite part of it. And it was so, everything was just so structured so perfectly. And we just loved the vibe. But
okay, but I know the internet not working. Okay then. Yeah, the internet.
Huh? Okay. Oh, nice, almost. Just so go in.
As soon as we got to Labasa, literally as soon as I paid the money at the resort, it just started pouring down raining. We came to celebrate my little cousin's birthday. She turned 11. And we still didn't let that ruin our trip. We actually waited for the rain to go down. Then after that, I got in the pool, got in the Lizzie River, and we still had our fun. I can go. my first time that I remember ever celebrating my mom's birthday. We originally I was planning a surprise birthday party for her, but after I heard about how Liberian people plan parties and everybody show up, I did not want to go through the headache, so I just ended up coming there, giving her the money, and she picked to go to the beach. And we still had a good time. She had fun. She was so happy, to have our family and all her friends there. And we were so happy to be there. My mom turned 49, so we celebrated my mom 49. This is the only birthday that I ever remember of my mom since I left her when I was 4 years old. So it was really nice just to celebrate her and just see how they get down, party with the grown folks. Look at that beautiful beach. So gorgeous. Also knew when we was coming to Liberia that we were going to be looking for land. We want to get a couple of lands in our possession because of projects and goals and aspiration that we have for our country. We definitely have that in our plans to come back home and see how we can contribute to our country and help our people really just get involved in the economy. So we toured like 3 lands this day. When I tell y'all, this was so exhausted because we walked, when I tell you we walked, like we walked all the way in the bushes for this one property, and then we went to another one. At the end of the day, I was exhausted. The whole day, I'm like, at the third land, I was like annoyed. I didn't want to talk. And it was nice because we had a couple of people that knew about land with us, so it wasn't something that we was doing by ourselves. And then of course we got like recommendation from people that knew someone that was selling, because when it comes to land buying, you have to be super careful and you have to do your due diligence yourself. But this is just the process. We just wanted to go and look and then come back and do our own evaluation to see what we want. So that was really nice to do.
I got it.
I record the whole thing, huh?
I know, I got it.
Now, I'm putting on my space.
Okay.
Look what you guys have.
I know, right? Well, oh, you got to pass through the bridge, too? What is it? What? It's oh, be careful. Y'all be careful. Hey, you got it? Go. Be careful.
Can we open the lens mode?
Yeah. Yeah.
This is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you got to see the beauty of Liberia, the good, the bad, the ugly. I love everything, every single thing about this country. I cannot wait until the day, God willing, we're able to go back home and just establish some projects, get some things under our belt, help our people, and just overall just enjoy the country, because this is a beautiful country and it's a lot to do. So thank you guys so much for coming. I'll see you guys in my next video.